Hello again, YouTube. Enzo back, bringing you another video review. And today we're going to be taking a look at the commander of the protectorbots hotspot. And I have to say, I was absolutely well chuffed to see this figure come out. It was nice to have a reimagined version of hotspot, who was also a combiner as well. So I was really excited when this figure came out. And also, he's a slightly tweaked version of onslaught from the combaticons, but we'll get into that another time. Yep, absolutely chuffed when this figure came out. And in hand, he doesn't disappoint as well. Really, really cool. He's a updated version. He's one of those, he looks a lot like Sentinel Prime from the movies. That kind of fire truck, but obviously with a ladder as well. But yeah, I think it works very, very well. The ladder does extend. It can just go up like that. It doesn't, you know, just tilt. It doesn't extend as you normally would, but that's okay. It's a tidy length of it, I think. Colour is spot on for hotspot. Nice two water cans on the back there. He rolls very well. Quick comparison. I just have sideswipe here at the moment, so you can see from a Deluxe and a Voyager. So, pretty cool how they scale together. There we go. And yeah, I do like this figure a lot. There's a lot of nice detail inside there. You can see the little studs there for the non-slip pads so somebody can stand there to fight fires. The nozzle, the ladder does do a full 360. You can go all the way around like that. And you can bend all the way back here. And you can bend like that. So whatever configuration you fancy, you can do it like that. So there's a lot of playability with this figure, even in vehicle mode. A lot of people don't like him because he's a bit thin. I have to agree, he's really, really thin here. Don't know why they put him on a diet, but there we go. You can see the hands moulded up there, but at least it's the same colour, so it's not too bad. And yeah, it is a very, very nice figure. A really nice updated version of Hotspot. And I like it. I don't know how many times I've said that, but I really do like it. So let me just take the guns off the side here. He comes with two pistols. Nicely detailed as well as fire hoses, so that looks good. And they've been a bit lazy on how they combine it for defense, so they just basically, that's it. They do an Optimus Prime and they just tab them together. That, in my opinion, is absolutely rubbish. I'm pretty sure Hasbro could have made the guns combined, could have used maybe two or three of the guns from the other figures and combined the weapon together. So when I do have him in defense, so I just use him as two pistols. Unfortunately, but oh well, never mind. That's what upgrade kits are for. So yep, very, very nice figure. Right, okay, let's get down with some transformation. First thing we do, lift that up out of the way. Come down here to the legs, take the front of the cab, fold them up, clip them in. That's all you need to do. Separate them like that, and then there's a double knee joint here now, and a lot of people don't like it, but they're tabbed in there with that little port. See there? You just need to push that out of the way, and then there we go, like that. Just break it like that, bring it down, and there we go. Now you've got the double knee mechanism there. What I tend to do is I need to push that in like that, so you get like a bit of an L shape, and then push it in then. And when you've got it lined up properly, you should tab in nice and secure. A lot of people think that he's got a he was broken or he's not supposed to be like that. But if you get the transformation right and you get it right, he tabs in securely and you can use those joints. Again, tab that in and yep, that is solid. And then you just rotate the thighs around like that. And that is the lower half of him done. Take the top half. You can't really see at the moment. Because he's gonna get tall. He's gonna get a big boy. So there we go. There we are like that. That's better. Just take the hands and separate them like that. Just bring them down. And then you just basically bring the backpack or the ladder like that. You just fold it down like that. Actually, no, I did it wrong. This is what I should have done first. You rotate it on that hinge like that. Then you fold it down, then you fold the ladder in, and you can see there's a post there, a post goes into that hole, and then same on both sides, and then that locks in like that. So you should end up with something like that. There we go. His knees come out. There we are, HotSpot. Bring down this panel here to bring out the head. Flip that back up. And then it's just a question of rotating the shoulders forward, bringing the arms down. Push this up against his back like that. And there we have it. That is HotSpot in robot mode. And he is absolutely, without a doubt, G1 accurate to the T. He is absolutely brilliant. If you remember the G1 toy, just had a black head and red eyes. This one is absolutely spot on. He is HotSpot. They've nailed the head sculpt for this figure. That is G1 HotSpot. From the dark blue faceplate to the red eyes to the helmet to these antennas, the colour, the chest, everything. It is HotSpot. Absolutely HotSpot. And he just looks, in robot mode, he looks really, you know, he looks good. He looks big and bulky and powerful. And he can just dual wield these rifles or pistols, which is what he usually did in the show. Obviously, they like to protect and serve and stuff like that. But obviously, when they do need to get into a fight, obviously, they could hold their own. And there was many a scene where HotSpot was seen dual wielding and blasting and just kicking ass, basically. Fair play to the protectorbots. They don't like to fight, but when they did fight, they kicked ass. And it's just a really, really nice figure. Very, very cool. A lot of people are saying he's skinny. And yeah, fair play, you know, looking like that, he is a bit skinny. But, you know, he's got the, and a lot of people don't like the ladder backpack. But I think, I don't mind it at all. I think it looks very cool. I really don't mind it at all. I think it looks absolutely brilliant. Let's bring in Streetwise, who I reviewed earlier. So we can see how they look together. So there's the buddies. And as a quick comparison and as a bit of a treat for everybody, let's bring in his fellow combiner, Torso Superior. So you can see the size difference there now. Obviously, he's gained an extra couple of feet because of the upgrade kit. But you can see there now, yeah. That looks pretty good, and I really can't wait to get the final members of Defensor up and running. So, there we go. Let's put him back to the side there now. And there we go. So, we'll get into the articulation. Head is on a ball joint. Can do the full 360. Can nod a little bit. This head sculpt is a bit better than the others. Feels like he's got a bit more motion. Shoulders on a really nice clickety ratchet joint, as you can hear there. Shoulders can move in and out. Double bend at the elbow. You'll see why in the next video. So he's got a double elbow joint there. No waist articulation, and I agree with a few other reviewers that they could have been. There's nothing really structural in here. I mean, if you just have a look in the back there, he's pretty much hollow. I'm pretty sure they could have put a mushroom peg waist joint in there. No, it doesn't have it, but you know, it doesn't matter. It doesn't spoil the figure, but they could have put a waist joint in there because obviously they've molded the wrists in, so there's no wrist articulation, which is a shame. Hips are on ratchets, so you can go 1, 2, 4 clicks out like that. Forward, mushroom peg thigh swivel. Can bend at the knee, and because of that, it's come out, there we go. Because of that, because of the gaps in the back of the legs there, you can get a really good, nice, deep knee bend like that, which I think is really nice. So you can utilise this figure in so many different ways. And you can get some really good poses. And because of the ladder as well, the ladder keeps him propped up. So there we go. Reckon HotSpot, should we do some Kimbo style? There we go. So he's ready to go there. Get him into some really nice poses. Yeah, yeah, I'm a badass. I am a badass. And yeah, I like him. I'm gushing over this figure. I really do like it. It is absolutely fantastic. It's a very, very nice updated version of HotSpot. And all the other protectorbots are great as well. And I really can't wait to get the other figures out because I'm desperate to do Defensor. I'm desperate to do it. It is a really, really nice figure. And it's great in vehicle mode. It's even better in robot mode. And the torso mode, the reforms as well, is just as good. Really, really, Hasbro, they don't do it often, but when they do something nice like this, they pull it off. They pull it off well. I have to say, where credit is due, Hasbro has done a really, really nice job with this figure. And in the protector bots and the aerial bots in general. Very, very nice. Now, there are two different upgrade kits for this figure. You can either get the Perfect Effects one, like Superion had, where you just have black version of the feet and hands. Or there's another one that's out in July. I forget the name, but basically every one of the protector bots gets an upgrade. And the Defensor combiner is a lot different as well. But I'll be doing a video on that now, just to bring everybody up to speed to see how much it is, where you can get it from, and what's included, and what you have to do, because there's quite a few modifications I've heard. So I think I will get myself the Reparables upgrade kit as well for this figure, just to get all the stickers going. You could use a little bit more paint, in my opinion, but again, I think he's brilliant. He's absolutely brilliant. Little flaw there now, that this shoulder tends to move a lot more than this one. So, it doesn't matter, but I just think it's absolutely brilliant. Nice Autobot symbol there on the chest, and that head sculpt, I just can't get over how cool that is. That is HotSpot. Brilliant. Nice big shoulders, big chest, dual cannons there. Got the ladder on the back there, which I don't mind at all. Really don't mind. He's brilliant in all three of his modes, robot, vehicle, and a torso. He is, without a doubt, a really good toy. I think in he's better than Superion, than Silverbolt in as a robot, because of the massive backpack that he had and things like that. But Superior for me, Torso is the better combiner so far at the moment. But yeah, he's a really, really nice figure. So there we are. Thank you very much. Diolch yn fawr. Please comment, rate and subscribe. Please stay tuned for more reviews. As soon as the other protector bots arrive, I will get them done, and I will get the Perfect Effects review done as soon as possible and bring that to you as well. Okay then, thank you very much, diolch yn fawr, and I shall see you all soon. Thank you, ta-ra.